not be showing that in public. So we beg your indulgence. We're not going to show that. I think inadvertently, our camera somehow got a glimpse, not very close, but so that you could actually discern that they were looking at a copy of a document.
Yes.
We're not supposed to show you that anymore, all right?
Okay. Well said, Tony. All right, Linda, Adele.
Yes, thank you, guys. We're joined here by defense spokesperson, Attorney Tranquil Salvador, and prosecution spokesperson, Congressman Sonny Angara. Good afternoon,
gentlemen. Good afternoon.
Panyeros, panyeros.
To the panel in the studio, Karen
well,
and Tony.
Paunahin ko na si Attorney Tranquil because you just had your press conference,
sure,
which
sure.
you also carried. Mm-hmm. Attorney Tranquil, how does the defense feel about the order of the court yesterday to produce the originals of the dollar deposit?
Of course, we're a bit concerned mm-hmm. because as mentioned by the president of PS Bank, ito po ay there's peso and dollar account. And in the manner by which they will examine it, baka naman we will be violating the temporary restraining order.
Mm-hmm.
When the temporary restraining order has been respected by the Senate, at the same time, ito po ay inisyo ng Supreme Court.
Mm-hmm.
Pero siyempre, hindi rin natin maiiwasan na our Senate as an impeachment court, ayaw nilang maggawa ng desisyon na hindi nila nakikita.
Mm-hmm.
Because of course, there is a witness who said that it is fake and spurious.
Mm-hmm.
But of course, I understand that they would want to make at least a comparison. That's why they would want to do some measures to limit it. Eh. Pero siyempre, kung ako masusunod, personal po, ayoko sana.
Mm-hmm.
Not that natatakot kami, pero makikita naman natin ang scrutiny is no longer on the contents. Eh. Is yun lamang yung opening documents, ito ba'y totoo o hindi?
Mm-hmm. So naiintindihan nyo naman, you don't feel that there is there seems to be an attempt to go around the TRO and the bank secrecy law para ma-uncover yung certain details.
Well, we respect them and mm-hmm. we give that presumption of regularity
mm-hmm.
na ayon sa batas na gagawin po tama. Dahil alam naman nila, sila naman mismo nagsabi, we respect the TRO. Eh.
Mm-hmm.
So, asahan po namin ganun. Mm-hmm.
Congressman Angara, the order came from the impeachment court upon the request or upon the motion of Senator Drilon. Ano? But how do you think will this affect or favor or be an advantage to your case as far as that's
actually
concerned?
To us, it's pretty much an irrelevant issue, honestly,
mm-hmm.
because we've always said that wasn't even presented in evidence. That was just in support of our request mm-hmm. for a subpoena. And it's been overtaken by events because napresenta na po namin yung testimonya ng bank officials.
Mm-hmm.
We've seen the bank accounts of Chief Justice Corona. And I think it's really more the defense and the senators who want to talk about this subject. Kami, as you notice, we're not really asking questions of the witness so much anymore. We're done with him. And we've gotten what we want out of the witnesses. So
mm-hmm.
We feel it has no bearing on admissibility. We think the defense is maybe trying to play it up because it's their last clear chance to invalidate the accounts that we've presented.
So Sonny, are you saying you're not going to submit that as evidence?
No,
that specific document?
It's not been marked as evidence.
Yes.
I think mm-hmm. that was established yesterday when Senator Enrile asked lead mm-hmm. prosecutor Tupas, have you marked this as your evidence? And he said, I have to check. And when he checked, it has not been marked.
Okay. Mm-hmm.
Kung hindi siya marked, will it be considered in that? Doon ako nalilito eh, kung hindi siya marked as evidence, will it be considered in the deliberations of the impeachment court? Ito yung konting confusion ngayon on documents that are kumbaga subpoenaed or requested by the senator judges.
Ganito po yan, ano? Kasi yan, pag when they make a decision, at the end of the day, they will examine all of the documents submitted to them. Maari pong totoo yon that there are documents that will be formally offered and properly marked and formally offered and accepted. Dapat po yun lang. Pero tandaan nyo po yan, dahil nagbabasa po yan eh. Nakita ni Manila yan, diniscuss dito yan. That is based on their supplemental application. And what is so important about this, kahit po sabihin nila na hindi ebidensya, this is the root of the subpoena. Na yan ang sinasabi nilang matibay nilang ebidensya, yung nakuha ng supinang ito. Kung ganun po, bakit naman sasabihin natin, ganun ba ang mga senator ba? Gusto lang pahabain ito? Tandaan nyo po, hindi kami nagtatanong. Sila ang nagtatanong. Mga 3 oras po kahapon, tinatanong yan. They would want to know whether this fake, whether this is leaked document. Bakit po? And I appreciate it. Personally, I appreciate what they're doing. Bakit po? Not because it's delaying the process, because they strengthen the process. Pag nakita ng mga kababayan natin, oh, pwede pala ang ang kahit anong ebidensya dyan. Di kung ano pong desisyon sa dulo niyan, baka maging questionable. Kung pakita ng mga senador natin na maayos ang prosesong ito, ang ebidensya lang na pinatunayan at dapat at tamang source ang papansinin namin dito. Di ang magpapakita kahit po anong resulta yan, kahit convicted si Chief Justice, ay respeto, kahit po acquitted yan.
So you're saying, Attorney Tranquil, that they should not consider that evidence the technically, diba? But if they do, if they do consider that, then is that, are you, and I want you to answer this question, are you laying the predicate, because some people are saying that the defense is laying the predicate for a mistrial.
No, ganito po, unahin ko muna bago yung mistrial na yan. Ano? Yung sinasabi lang hindi ebidensya, kaya nga po nila inattach yun, dahil they want to see the opening statements, the opening documents of the bank. Mm-hmm. Kaya lang po, kaya nga rin kami nagtaka, bakit nauna yung hinihingi nila? Huwag po natin sabihin hindi. Because in due time, baka ho mamamarkahan din yan eh. Mm-hmm. Ngayon lang ho, hindi pa. Kaya hinihingi nga nila. Di ba, dami lang. Pati ending balance, hinihingi. Ngayon, opening balance, hinihingi. Ngayon, ito po sasabihin natin yung mistrial. Kasi po, nakita ko nga yung nag-banner headline din sa isang periodiko. Susundin ko pong sinabi ni Senate President, ating pong nire-respeto. Sabi niya, walang mistrial dito. It's just a question of acquittal and conviction. Ang pwede lang po mangyari, again, with all due respect sa ating mga prosecution, no, is pwedeng isipin nila na, naku, baka kailangan ata i-configure natin ang konting complaint or baguhin natin para tiyakin natin na talagang matanggal siya. Sandali, mag-rethink tayo. Pero po yung kami, mag-mistrial, at to be honest with you, hindi po eh. Sa, susundin ko yung tinutukan na Senate President, sabi niya, dalawa lang yan, acquittal, conviction. Ganun po yan.
Congressman.
Yeah, 2 points, no? Dun sa question of whether that attachment to the request for subpoena, which is alleged to be fake, mm-hmm. or some say it's authentic. Sa akin, if you don't mark it, it's not formally offered in evidence. I think any third-year law student taking up evidence will tell you, mm-hmm. it's not going to be considered by the court.
Mm-hmm. It should not be considered by the court.
Mm-hmm. What the court should consider is the testimonies of the witnesses and the documents they present and which are marked, mm-hmm. and offered in evidence.
Okay.
Do naman sa mistrial, I think that's just the fear of some that. That if the defense gets an adverse decision here, that they may do that. But as of now, I guess that's fairly remote. No?
Okay.
Liliwanagin ko lang, ano, kasi yung puntong yan, sila pa lang ho nagpipresenta ng ebidensya, eh. Hindi pa po kami.
Mm-hmm. Yan ang baka pinis- But I did hear Justice Cuevas say, make a reference to a mistrial yesterday.
Naalala ko po, nabanggit niya lang yun. Pero po yun sa tinutukoy ko ebidensya, baka kasi mga mamaya yan, dahil magpipresenta kami, sabi namin in due time, markahan namin yan. Kaya hindi pwede na sabihin hindi na maging ebidensya. Mm-hmm. It's very early in the day mm-hmm. to say that would not be used. Kasi po, ang ugali naman ng tao usually, pag hindi pabor sa akin, abay, ngayon, ako, tagilid ako rito. Huwag na muna. Hindi na muna. Kasi po, hindi pa tapos eh. Mm-hmm. Mahaba pa po, Article 1 eh. Baka pag kami nagpresenta, markahan po namin lahat yan. Hindi ko po sinasabing gagawin namin. Mm-hmm. But there is a possibility that we will do that.
Mm-hmm. Okay. And then just a quick question to Congressman Angara. Is there a possibility that we'll take up Article 3 today? Kung matapos tayo doon sa bank officials.
Yolinda, the commentators have been asking me that for the whole week. And I've been saying I hope so. So I really, really hope so today. Yeah.
And then, of course, I know that you mentioned earlier in your press conference, which you also carried na...